Hi, my name is Riata Scott, and today I'm going to show you how to create multiple columns in CSS3. I'm using Dreamweaver CC here so that we can see the design view as we work, but I'll type directly into the source code and the style sheet so that those of you who are using a text editor like Notepad can follow along with the steps. In this example, we have a story with text that spans the width of the section, but I'm going to show you how to split the content into two or more columns. We're going to use the column properties of CSS3 to reorganize this page into the three columns. And let's just take a look at the source code. All of this content is contained in an article tag here. And to that tag, I've applied the classes columns and rounded. Rounded is just to create these little rounded corners, and I've applied that class to images and things as well. So we can ignore that one, but we're going to take a look at columns. So let's go over here to our style sheet. And this is the columns class right now, and right now it just has information about how wide it is and margins and things like that. We're going to add the column properties right here, and I'll talk a little bit about each one as we go along. So the first one I want is column hyphen count, and of course we add our colon, and then we'll put our values in here. And the value is simply how many columns you want. And I'm going to make it 3. Put my semicolon so that I can start a new property here. All right, so column count 3. Next thing we want is column hyphen gap. We'll do a colon there. And that's just how thick we want the gap between columns. And I'm going to just go with 10 pixels here. So 10px and then my semicolon. Next one is column rule. And column rule has 3 different properties. Actually, you can see this in the hint that's showing up on Dreamweaver right here. So there's column rule color, column rule style, and column rule width. And they actually have to go as width, style, and color in that order if you combine them all. And that's what we're going to do here. So instead of each of those separate, we'll just do column rule and our colon, and then we will type in the thickness. And I'm just going to say thick, and then a space, not a comma, and I'm going to do this one dashed. Most people would probably use solid. That's the one you use the most. And finally, I'll put in a color, and I'm just going to say green to be easy. And we'll put our semicolon, and we'll put our final property in, and that is column fill. This one is not necessarily supported by everything, but we're going to put balance here, and that will balance the columns out so that they're pretty even where they end, hopefully. All right, so I'm going to just click Save All. Obviously, if you're just in Notepad, you just make sure you save any changes you made. And in this case, we only change stuff in the styles. And let's take a look at this in some different browsers and see how it's going so far. And it is not obviously showing up in my view here. So we'll just look at browsers and see how it's showing. I'm going to take a look in Chrome. It is not working in Chrome. We still just have one column. Let's try Firefox. It is also not working in Firefox. And finally, we'll try good old Internet Explorer. And that's just crazy. Can you believe that? Internet Explorer is ahead of the game in making columns work. We still have some problems here, like this just doesn't look very good. We've got the heading all squished in one column, and then other columns start kind of near the top here. So we'll have to do a little bit more tweaking. But we also need to take care of the fact that it's not working in the other browsers. So I'll do that next. Now, before I show you how we can get this columns property to work in some of the other browsers, let me show you something you might find really useful. You can go to caniuse.com, and we have different CSS properties, HTML5, and some other things that we can look up and find out how your browser or various browsers support that. So I'm just going to type in columns. And right up the top, we see CSS3 multiple column layout. And I had clicked a button earlier that said I wanted to see US percentages. So if we hover over different versions, in this case this is Internet Explorer, we'll see in red that the columns properties are not supported in 6, 8, or 9. But the green shows us that it's completely supported in IE10 and IE11. Let's go over here and check out the different versions of Firefox. All of these are in this lighter green, which means it's partially supported. And you'll see that it says, I can't point at it because it goes away when I do that, but you'll see where it says partial support with prefix hyphen MOZ hyphen. So that's what we're going to do, is add these vendor prefixes to our styles in a moment. That's how we'll get them to work. Chrome, same thing, just partial support. In this case, we need to use the vendor prefix hyphen WebKit hyphen. And this Safari will work with WebKit as well. Opera is also WebKit, and so forth. WebKit. So let's go on back to our website and our page. So what we'll do, come down here and let's highlight column fill, well, column count through column fill, get all of that, and then I'll use Control C on my keyboard, and I'm going to paste it twice more. So there is once and twice. And I accidentally have this indented, but that's fine because now I can see where these things start. So let's start with the vendor prefix MOZ, and then I will copy that and paste it in front of column gap, column rule, and column fill. Now, some of these may not work even with the vendor prefix, but we'll see in a moment what is working. And now we'll add to the other four that we copied, we'll add hyphen WebKit hyphen, and then I will copy that, Control C, and I'll paste Control V in front of column gap, column rule, and column fill. And then we'll save this and take a look at it in the different browsers. So we already know that Internet Explorer is working. So next I will try Chrome. Go up here and refresh. All right, that WebKit prefix did help this work. Now we still have a little problem with things coming up here, and I would like this to span all the way across the columns, the header, but we'll check that in a minute. Let's look at Firefox. There's Firefox, and I will refresh it. And the columns are working there as well. So we have a little bit of tweaking to do, but the vendor prefixes did help us at least get the columns in there. So let's go back to our HTML editor, and we're going back into our styles.css document, and I'm going to add something so that this H1 tag, this heading here, will span across the three columns. So we'll use the columns class again, and we'll use H1 as the selector, and we're going to use a new property called column hyphen span. I'll add my colon, and you only have a couple of choices. You can span it across one column, which it's already doing, so that's the default, or all. It would be nice if you could just span it across two, maybe because you wanted to leave that third column, you know, coming up at the top. But we don't have that choice. It's just one or all. So we'll go ahead and say all, and I'll save this, and we'll take a look at the different browsers and see if it's working. Let's start with Internet Explorer, since that one worked for us last time. So we'll refresh, and it is working. That H1 tag is spanning the three columns. Let's try Chrome. Fresh. Does not work here. Probably needs the WebKit prefix. And what about Firefox? Refresh, and that one doesn't work. So we will try the MOZ prefix. So once again, I'm going to Control C to copy that property. And I'll Control V to paste it twice more. Then I'll add the vendor specific prefixes, MOZ or hyphen, MOZ hyphen, and hyphen WebKit hyphen. Then we'll save. And then let's open up Chrome and refresh once again. Yay, that works. What about Firefox? Refresh, no help. So Firefox isn't up with the game on that. So let me just show you something that you could also do instead. We could just come out here to the HTML. So let's find the beginning of this article in the HTML. And I'd hate to do this because then it's not in our article again, but we could just pull the H1 out so that it's above our article section if you really had your heart set on that going all the way across. So let's do that, and I will hit save, open Firefox again, and refresh, and there it does come across there. You also probably need to put a little padding in here so that it's not right up against our logo at the top, but for the most part things are working. I'm going to do a little bit of cleanup here with things like the wrapping. That doesn't really work very well with columns. We probably, that's a very small image and it could just go in the top or somewhere. So you're always going to have to tweak a few things, but for the most part it works pretty well. Oh, and by the way, this is how the balance works. It tries to make sure that they're pretty close at the bottom. And let's take a look at, it seems balance is pretty much working here as well. What about Internet Explorer? Internet Explorer does not seem to support the balance part, so we've got a bunch of gap here instead of those things going up. So I'm not sure what's going on there. You'll just have to make some decisions. Maybe add some more pictures down here if you really have your heart set on it balancing. But that's about it for columns and how to use vendor prefixes in our properties.